Hello, 3D printing friends. Today on the BB3D channel, we're going to take a look at AIO Robotics Bright Blue PLA. Stick around and we'll get into it right after this. I'm Brian, and you are watching BB3D. Hi everyone, welcome back. I want to take a quick moment before we get started to thank all of you who subscribed to the channel because it really helps the channel out. Thanks, I truly appreciate it. And if you haven't subscribed, it's easy. Just click that subscribe button down there. Okay, so today we're taking a look at AIO Robotics PLA, and this is the bright blue color. This spool is part of a 12-color AIO Robotics PLA filament bundle, which I received as a Christmas gift from my parents. Thanks, Mom and Dad. If you purchase this as a single roll, the filament is US $13.99 for a half kilogram spool. That sounds inexpensive, but most spools are 1 kilogram spools, so the equivalent cost for that amount of AIO Robotics PLA is close to US$28. And that's a mid-range price for PLA, although filament in general is getting cheaper all the time. Now, for any filament I use, I want to know how it performs in certain key areas. So I came up with a testing method that I think will provide a fair assessment of a filament's performance characteristics. The first thing I print is a temperature tower with a temperature range suitable for the filament I'm testing. This allows me to see how the filament performs across a range of temperatures. Then I choose the temperature that gave the best looking result and print a suite of models to further test the filament. In order to test how well the filament can bridge unsupported gaps, I print a bridging test file. To test the filament's resistance to stringing when I use my standard retraction settings, I print a retraction test file. I also print a common benchmarking model, Daniel Nare's 3D Benchy. It has a variety of curves, inclines, small bridges, holes, etc. I print a CaliCat calibration model to get an idea of the surface finish on boxy models, and also because it's a cat, and also because my wife says I have printed way too many benchies. And I print the Aria Dragon, designed by Louise Driggers, because dragons! But also because she said on Twitter that all her dragons were meant to be calibration objects. And Aria is a good dragon to print. She tests a nice variety of things. Stringing, overhangs, fine pointy bits, and reproduction of details. And with Aria, you can get a good idea of how a filament performs on a more organic type of model. So that's the test suite. Now let's look at how the filament is packaged. The filament comes enclosed in a cardboard box with a label indicating the type, color, weight, diameter, and temperature range. Inside the box, the filament is vacuum sealed with a desiccant pack in a resealable bag. And that's a nice touch. I prefer resealable bags, but only about half the filament I buy includes them. The filament is on a plastic spool, and the spool includes the same label as the cardboard box. But the spool's not marked with a recycling symbol, so since there's no way of knowing exactly what kind of plastic it's made out of, you can't just toss it in the recycle bin when you use the last of the filament. But because these half-kilogram spools are small, you can keep them around to load sample filament onto if you subscribe to a filament sample box, such as the Alien 3D UFO Mystery Box or the Maker Box. Well, now that we know a little bit about how the filament is packaged, how does it perform? Let's find out. Here is the temperature tower I printed. Overall, it printed really well across the entire temperature range. Overhang performance was good across the entire range, but its ability to bridge gaps was best at the cooler temperatures. Based on the results from the temperature tower, I decided to print the rest of the test suite at 200 degrees C. All the models were sliced with Slicer Prusa Edition, and apart from the temperature tower, all of these were printed with a 200 degree nozzle on a 60 degree bed. I sliced these using my typical print settings that I use when I print pretty much anything that isn't a draft print. I used a 0.2 millimeter layer height, 15% infill, and a speed of 40 millimeters per second. And I sliced these using my 3-4-5 process. That's 3 perimeters, 4 bottom layers, and 5 top layers. And I print the outermost shell at 20 millimeters per second for a smoother finish. I printed them all on a Monoprice Maker Select Plus 3D printer, which is a rebranded Wanhao Duplicator i3 Plus. Let's take a look at the results. Here's the bridging test. The AIO Robotics PLA performance is very good on all the bridges. The longest bridge spans nearly 52 millimeters, and there was a slight bit of sagging, but all the layers are still touching. If you were printing a model that needed to span a pretty large gap, you could probably get away with skipping supports. But if you need dimensional accuracy on an internal void, for instance, if you have an opening in a print that another part is supposed to fit into, you should still use supports. I did notice a very slight amount of stringing between some of the more closely spaced columns on this bridge test, but the strings are very, very fine. Moving along, here's the retraction/stringing test. The columns are straight, and there's just a few fine wispy strings at the bottom. There's not much more to say about this test, given how well it printed. Next is Daniel LeRae's 3D Benchy. The AIO Robotics PLA produced a very nice Benchy. The overhang angles on the bow printed with absolutely no problems. The fine details in the wheelhouse turned out well, the window openings and doorway arches printed well, and the overall surface finish is nice. There is, again, a very slight bit of stringing inside the wheelhouse. The smokestack printed with no issues, and I'm pleased with how it turned out. On to the Calicat. This turned out really well, too. The tail, in particular, turned out phenomenally well. Because the tail has such a small cross-section, some filament has trouble on the 45-degree angle of the tail, and will show a bit of curling or other imperfection, but this was absolutely perfect. The rest of the Calicat is equally nice, the surface finish is smooth, and if I had to find a fault, it would be the two strings between its front paws. But come on, it's a cat. They play with strings all the time. Now it's time for the Aria Dragon by Luis Driggers. The fine detail on the toes is amazing, and the legs turned out great. There was one spot on the chest between the shoulders where the extreme overhang resulted in a loop of filament drooping down, but the rest of the model had no problems. The thin wings printed perfectly with just a few strings in between. I love this model. It turned out really well in the AIO Robotics Bright Blue PLA. So here are the test suite results, printing models at 200 degrees on a 60-degree bed. Bridging performance, very good. Minimal sagging. Stringing performance, very good. A few fine, wispy strings. Benchy performance, excellent. Calicat performance, excellent. Aria performance, excellent. Overall, I think this is a good filament for the price. Its performance is very good across the board, and I've had absolutely no problems printing with it. Is AIO Robotics PLA the cheapest filament money can buy? No, not at all. But is it a filament I'm comfortable recommending? Yes, absolutely. Of the two spools that I got in the bundle, I have printed with the bright blue PLA and the red PLA. And I like them both, and wow, is that red? Red. So far, the two have performed equally well, and therefore I'm comfortable recommending AIO Robotics PLA in general. If I run into any issues with the remaining colors, I'll be sure to make a follow-up video. There are links to Amazon in the description for the bright blue PLA and the 12-color bundle. At the time of this video, the bundle is out of stock, but you can purchase the colors individually. Well, that's the end of the episode. I hope you liked this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down, but either way, leave your thoughts in the comments. If you like the content I'm producing, please consider supporting the channel with a one-time micropayment. You could buy me a coffee or leave a little something in the PayPal tip jar. Links for those are in the description. So while I've got this bright blue PLA, I think I'm going to go print something cool. You do the same, and I'll see you next time.